It sure will. Yes, we are. Cannot wait to see how much snow comes down across the Sierra. Now, Jacqueline showed you that rough commute out there this morning. At least there isn't rain to mess with too many people. But the rain is happening to the north. Of course, Eureka, looks like Redding will be getting some rainfall. Highway 101, well to the north of us, getting that rain now on our high-def Doppler. You can see it. It's way up there, but it's going to move its way down. What we are seeing is just some mist out there. You may see a few raindrops, but it's not going to be the type that will cause any measurable precipitation this morning. Later on, though, this afternoon, that's when you'll start to see it. Visibility, though, definitely a concern out there this morning. This is a big problem down in San Jose. 1.5 mile visibility right now. Hayward, 2.5. Livermore, it's improving just a little bit at 2.5 to 5 mile visibility, but the airports also could face some delays, and driving through the North Bay will be tough going with those low clouds. Here's a look at our wind speeds right now. We're going to start to see those winds picking up, though. East southeast winds at 7 miles per hour sustained right now. Hayward, just 5. It's a lot calmer in Nevada right now, San Rafael as well, and calm in Santa Rosa, and that's why that fog is lingering. Here's a view of the Bay Bridge normally, but right now it's covered in a layer of fog. 52 degrees for San Francisco right now, 49 in Livermore, 52 in Oakland. Get ready for colder air to settle in. Across the South Bay today, temperatures upper 50s, 10 degrees drop from yesterday when we were in the upper 60s across the South Bay. 58 for the high in San Francisco, 55 will be the high in Santa Rosa. The early morning lows will be very chilly, so tomorrow we'll start to feel that cooler air, same with Friday morning. So here's what's all associated with this storm system. We're going to have Sierra snow, high surf, colder air, wind, and the rain isn't even the main part of this system at all. The rain totals are not that impressive the next couple days. Here's the amount we'll most likely see. Places like Ukiah, Santa Rosa will get pretty much the most amount of rain from the storm. Maybe 3/4 of an inch for Ukiah, almost a half inch expected for Santa Rosa across the North Bay, and about 1/4 of an inch for the rest of the Bay Area through San Francisco, Redwood City, San Jose, even less than that. But the snow is going to be pretty impressive. So it's a colder storm. That means low snow levels could drop as low as 3,500 feet. Donner Summit could see about 15 inches, 8 inches for South Lake Tahoe. So lake level, they should get a nice coating of fresh powder. And those ski resorts up at those ridge tops could get 2 feet of snow. Wind gusts are also going to be very strong with this one. Here's a look at your Tahoe report. Alpine Meadows expecting wind and snow today, and Squaw Valley as well. The snow is going to last through Friday, even into Saturday morning for places like Sugar Bowl also. So high surf also with this thing. So we're looking at waves as high as 18 to 22 feet, breakers up to 40 feet. So that, of course, could be a big problem. And we're already seeing it battering the coastline across Washington and Oregon, and San Francisco will certainly be impacted here this afternoon through tomorrow with that high surf warning in effect. Another chance of rain Sunday, Monday, and a third chance on Wednesday. And that is your forecast.